An early morning dash home has turned into a tricky recovery mission after a carload of young men flipped their vehicle into the Cooks River at Campsie. Rescuers were left scratching their heads as to how the small sedan managed to get there.
Wrong way up in a cold, dark Cooks River, a night out that didn't go to plan.
Woke up and I heard the noise.
Three men in their 20s were in this car when it went flying over the bridge ledge at Fifth Avenue Campsie at 3:30 this morning. Two managed to scramble out, another was stranded in the water.
We put a ladder down to him. One of our firefighters went down into the river with him and assisted him up the ladder.
Drenched and hospitalised with minor head injuries with a few questions to answer.
I have got no idea how they have left the road. The road is reasonably straight.
Police suspect the driver had been drinking at a friend's house nearby, but also believe they could have been speeding.
They're very lucky to be alive, considering the distance they did leave the bridge and landed into the river.
The car has been leaking oil and fuel all day, a spectacle for droves of curious locals.
I can't believe they got out of that. That's actually a bad crash.
Well, that's amazing. That's a first. That's... I've been riding along here for a long time and I've never seen a car in there before.
Somehow the car now needs to come out. That's a job for a crane sometime tonight.
OK, let's go live to Danielle Post at the scene in Campsie. Danielle, the process has begun.
It certainly has, Pete. Good timing. The tow truck is just moving into place now and the plan is that it will reverse up to the edge of the bridge here. It will extend its crane out and lift the car out of the Cooks River. But first, the tow truck driver's got to get into the water and chain up that vehicle. But take a look at this. There's quite a crowd growing here. The locals here have been following this story all day and they will be happy when this car is out of their river here at Campsie. As for the driver, Pete, we're told he had an overseas license and police expect to lay charges.
Danielle, thank you.